Hi everyone, it's Vicky here with another art journal after popular demand. I am working on my Ranger art journal and I am going to cover up both pages with some tissue paper. This is old tissue paper by Tim Holtz, but you can always use a page of an old book or even a stamp with text all over your pages. To stick the tissue paper on my pages, I am using Matte Medium by Ranger and I am applying it with my brush. Once this is dry, I am going to use my scissors and cut out the excess. This is a lovely pattern paper pad that's 6x6 and it is called Sue Lovely. It's by Cartabella, and although it's an old collection, I will try to find links on various places where you can probably get it. Now, I have picked up some of those pattern papers that have a swing pattern on them, so I am using my scissors to cut out some of those swing patterns because I want to create my own background using all those little things. So here are all the little pieces that I have cut out, ready to go, but before I go ahead and stick them on my pages, first I am going to spray my pages with water and then I am going to apply some gesso. I will apply it with my brush, and I did spray with water because I want to dilute this gesso because it's kind of thick, so it doesn't cover up the whole background. This is a technique I usually do when I want to push a design more at the background. So once this is dry, I will go ahead and apply a couple of colors. These are distress paints. They are actually fluid acrylics that they dry quickly and they become permanent once they are dry. Now first I have applied Tattered Rose, which seems to be very light, and that's why I decided to apply it with my fingers, because the baby wipe kind of dilutes the color and make it even paler. Once this layer is dry, I will go ahead and apply a lot of Victorian Velvet, which is a little bit darker, and this actually is going to add color to my page. I am again applying it with my fingers just because I want to keep the vibrancy of the color, and I don't want to make it paler if I would apply it with my baby wipes. And here is the final result after sticking all those little pattern pieces on my background. Now I am going to again do the same technique with gesso, just applying a gesso wash all over those little pieces, and this is going to make sure that all the designs are pushed back at the background, while at the same time you can still see them. And once that's done, then it is time to add some color. I will apply wild honey all over them. At the beginning, I was applying the color with the dabber, which made it very vibrant for my liking, so I decided to go ahead and use a baby wipe to apply everything. So now that I have a base color for my background, I am going all over it with distress ink, and this time I am applying it with my blending tool, and I am applying Vintage Photo. This is going to create some shadows and make it more vibrant. Once that's done, I will go ahead and use my trusted brown big brush marker, and I am going all over the edges to add some shadow only on the edges. And as you can see, I keep working on my background until I am happy with the colors. Nothing is pre-planned, I just have an idea of what I want to do. For example, for this page, I know that I want to use a body form and I know the quote, but for the background, I just go wherever that takes me. This is where I decided to add some highlighting on all those pieces. So I am using my white big brush marker on the edges and just smudge them with my finger. at this stage, I am quite happy with the background. So all I am doing is adding some splashes. Now I am using diluted gesso with a thin brush, and I am using thin brush because I can control the splashes better and I get those tiny little ones instead of big splashes. I have used my Silhouette digital cutter to cut out this body form, and I am going to give you a link down below in the description area on where I got this digital file. But I know there is a C6 die by Tim Holtz that cuts out one of those body forms, as well as many stamps, which you can always stamp and cut out with your scissors. To color the wooden parts of my body form, I am using black soot first, and then I will cover it with antique bronze to give it a more wooden look and add that shine on the wood that I want. For the main body, I am going to be using this sticky back canvas that gives a great texture on the body form. So I have stuck it down on the body, and now I'm cutting out the excess with my scissors. To color it, I will be using some distress stain, and that's spun sugar. And just because the distress stain is very liquid, you will see that it will start to peel off from the back, but that's nothing I cannot fix with some tacky glue. So now I am going to add some shadows around the body form using vintage photo and Victoria Velvet, and I am applying everything with my blending tool. To decorate my body form, I decided to cut out this stitched flower, and I am using my Simon Says stamp dies for that. So just to color the flower a little bit, I am adding a touch of yellow at the center towards the outside of the petals without touching at all the outside. Now I want this flower to look white. I have created a brown center for my daisy, but you will see that later on I will cover it up. I decided to cover it up with a button. I am using my matte medium to stick this down on the body form, and then I will stick the whole body form on my page. And just like I do with all my focal points, when I stick them on my pages, I will go all around the body form with my brown marker to add some shading. I am lightly touching the page with my tip of the marker to apply a little bit of Indian ink, and then I am smudging everything with my finger. And again, once I am happy with the shadows around the body form, I will use my thin black marker to add some sketched lines around the body form, and also I will use my white gel pen to add some highlights. These are word stickers by Tim Holtz. They come in white and black, and I am picking three different ones from those words to create a cluster around my body form. So I have decided to go with Imagine, Create, Inspire. And when you are using stickers on your layouts, it's always a good idea to go over them with some matte medium just to make sure that they will not peel off. Now I am going to create a border. I am using this stamp which adds a nice stitching all around, and this is by Limor Weber. And I am applying some vanilla embossing powder. And just like always, I will link all the supplies used on this page just below the video in the description area, as well as on my blog. I am also trying to link to various places where you can probably find the supplies in case some of them are sold out. Now I would normally do the same technique, adding the border with my border stamp on the other page, but this is where I decided that I wanted to add a real zipper. So I am going to show you how I did it. This is the first time that I did it, but it worked pretty well. So I am drawing a line with my ruler, and I am going to extend the line as far as I want my zipper to be. I am making a mark with my pencil, and then I will use my scissors to cut out along the line. And this is where you need to be extra careful so that you don't cut another page, which I did, but let's pretend that that never happened. So now I am going to make a mark 1 inch on one side and on the other from that line. And the idea is to create a triangle, which I am going to cut with my scissors. Adding a zipper is a great element on your art journal layouts, as well as on your scrapbooking layouts on your albums, because although it adds that different texture, it's not that bulky at the same time. So after I have my triangle ready there, I am going to use some tacky glue at the back and secure the zipper. So although it looks kind of complicated, it's not really. I am using my scissors to cut out the top of the zipper that goes outside of the page, as well as the back, since I don't want to have all that bulk at the back of my page. I am securing the end with some double-sided tape. Now all that's left to do is to cover up the back somehow, so I am trying to decide which pattern paper I will be using. And I am going to go with that black and white one, since it matches perfectly the black elements that I already have on my page. I am going to cut out a piece of that pattern paper and secure it at the back with some tape adhesive. And then I am going to stick both those pages with some double-sided tape. You can always go with a gel medium or any type of adhesive that you have. Now that my zipper is in place, I will go ahead and do some shadowing. So first of all, I will be using my distress paint, and that's Victorian Velvet, and I'm just lightly going over the zipper with the dabber. and I am going to use my brown big brush marker to go around the edges of the zipper to add some shadow, and finally I will be adding some faux stitching with my white gel pen. And for those of you who have trouble using the white gel pen, look how I am starting out my pen once I get no results on my finger. So now it's working perfectly. I will go ahead and do some faux stitching, not only around the zipper, but also around all those patterns that I have sticked down on my background. At this stage, the main layout is finished, so all that's left to do is to add, of course, the quote and do the finishing touches. So with my white big brush marker, I'm adding some highlights on the form, the body form. And of course, I do need to continue the embossed border around the second page. So I am going to do that using again the same stamp and the same embossing powder. And when I finish a layout, I can go ahead and add details forever. So this is where I decided that I wanted to use, as the center of my flower, one of those hood veneer buttons. So I am threading this white floss through the button, and you can see that it helps me to add a little bit of gel medium at the edge. So now it threads easily. And now I'm going to secure it at the center of the flower using a glue dot, and then I am going to tie a bow. And just because I have a few black elements, I am going to add some black splashes. And for this I am using some black acrylic paint diluted with water, and again my thin brush. Using splashes with colors that you already have in some elements on your layout is a great tip for bringing everything together. I am going with my white gel pen around those stickers. And now I am going to add the quote. For my quote today, I am combining alphabet stickers along with stamping with an alphabet stamp set. So I am going to be using these wood veneer stickers by Prima, which I wanted to be black. So I decided to use my big brush marker and just color them the color that I want. And I am going with a quote that says, "Creativity never goes out of style." One of my favorite finishing touches is helping the quote pop out. So I am using my white gel pen and adding some highlights on the letters here and there. And this is of course where I would normally finish with my layout, but I decided that I had enough empty space on both my pages, and I remembered that I didn't use my favorite technique, which is applying embossing paste over a stencil. So with my spatula, I am going to apply some white embossing paste over this lovely stencil, which is by Prima. And notice that I apply only a little bit of the embossing paste. I'm not going heavily over the stencil, and that's because I want this to be quite of transparent when it dries. You will see what I mean at the close-up photos at the end of the video. So that was the layout for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me a thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of my project. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more art journal layouts that I made a while ago. Click on any of the videos on screen right now, or if you're watching from a mobile device, you can find links to both those videos down below in the description area, as well as on the info card that just popped on your screen. Thank you all for watching!